Hi everybody and welcome to lesson 14. Just once again a look at the project talk. This week we looked at all the guys that were there and just asked them to name who their team member was and then to just give a brief indication of the theme of their project. Most of the guys had ideas, were in teams, and it varies mostly along the gaming section, but there are some people that are going to be doing a bit of a demonstration type thing. Okay, so a reminder just to get going with the projects. Only a few weeks left. Time flies by faster than you think. Last time, if you recall, we looked at the list data type. We looked at creating lists, how to manually populate them, how to then use the code, to use command blocks to actually access, to add items, insert items, remove items, and then to access items at a particular position in the list. And then we used lists to change the way that the original address terror program worked and to rather use a list to remember all the offset values and initial position values rather than having multiple sprites, one sprite per costume. We could get away with having a single sprite with multiple costumes. This week, or today's mission, we're going to be looking at the two string functions that Scratch offers. So basically, if you think about it, a string is just a list of single letter characters. So if you look at the little diagram on the right hand side here, you'll see that this is sort of how a string is stored. So each letter is held in a little position within the string, and then you can then actually work your way through the string and ask, well, what letter is at position 6? And we'll tell you, well, there's the letter I, position 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And so forth. There's also a function we'll look at which tells you what the full length of the string is, so you know how long to loop through or to loop around to be able to access the full length of the string. Once we've looked at the functions, we're going to write two quick applications. The first one will be spell my name, and the second one will be the encryptor. Okay, so looking at the functions, once again, if you look at a variable, let's call the variable name, and we've set that name to Karin. Here you can see the Karin is made up of 5 letters. Okay, so you can say, what is letter 2 of name? And that's exactly what this function is. It says, give me the letter at position, whatever I give you, 4 of the variable that I'm asking about. So I'll give you the 4th letter of Karin, which is E. The length of variable function will tell you how long this particular word is. So the length of Karin will be 5. So if we want to go through each one of the letters, we can say, well, repeat 5 times and move along one position each time and give me the letter at each position. And we'll see exactly how we do that shortly in our spell my name application. Okay, analyzing a string's characters. Now this is a bit more of a complicated exercise and you can try to do it yourself. In this particular example, what you're looking at is you're saying, well, enter a sentence and then tell me how many vowels, letters A, E, I, U, were in my sentence. So the beginning part of the this function is pretty easy. It's just basically using the ask function. It says, please enter the sentence and wait, and then sets or clears your two control variables. So this one's going to store how many letters or how many vowels are in my sentence, and the second one is your position one. Well, basically it's going to be used to step through each of those positions in the sentence and then analyze the letter at each position. So repeat, now we're using the length of function, so the repeat length of answer. So let's pretend our sentence is enter a sentence. So the length of that will be 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So it's going to basically repeat 16 times this function. It's going to set the ch variable. So now that's your actual variable at letter position of answer. So when it comes in for the first time, position is going to be 1. So it's effectively saying, give me the letter at position 1 of my answer. And if that was our thing we entered, the first letter would be E. It's going to set ch, the variable ch, or ch for character, going to set that to E, and say if character equals A or E or I or O or U, then, in this case it is an E, so it's going to be true, change my vowel count by 1. Having set this to 0, your vowel count will now be 1. And if not, basically there's no else loop, so it's going to do nothing, and it's going to say, okay, now change my position by 1, so position I goes to 2. It's going to go and repeat this loop again, set char to letter 2 of answer, letter 2 was the N. Is N there? No. Step out of the left loop and keep going. And repeat that number of times. And when you're finished, it's going to say, join your sentence has, let's call it 10. I'm not going to count quickly. It says 10 vowels in there. So it's your join 10 to vowels. It's going to say your sentence has 10 vowels. And this is basically how you can quickly analyze a sentence and work out how many vowels there are, how many numbers there were in your sentence, how many capital, you can't really tell capital and lowercase, unfortunately. But you can say how many spaces were in my sentence, how many punctuation marks, or whatever. How many letters were in my sentence, well, that's an easy one, you just use that function there. And then you would use this to go and analyze deeper into each letter and see what's there. Okay, so this is on your thumb drives. You can go and open this up and have a look there. Under sessions 15-16, like we mentioned last week, we are jumping around a bit now to just give you more exposure to the later functions so that you can use them in your projects or in your other little application you might want to write. Okay, now this one is a more advanced function. It's also on session 15-16 called Fix My Spelling. And this is an example of where you start off with a string and you want to insert a character or a string in the middle of that string. So basically doing an insert in the middle of a string. And in this particular case, what we're saying is giving the word help, so my startup string is help, I want to add the letter W to position 3. And then give me the answer out. So we start off with help, go to position 1 to add the letter W, and we get hello. And effectively this is just like a spelling test application, but it shows you the principle of how you would insert a character or a word into the middle of another sentence or word. So if you have a long sentence and you want to start off with saying my name is, or your name is blah and you are a boy or a girl, whatever, you might not know what the name is, so later you'll say, you'll start the sentence, my name is blank and you are a blank, and you can set the words name and boy or girl, whatever you want later on. So just looking at the functions, so we're not looking at all the code, but just the function that actually does it. We've got our string add, which is that one there, into string in, which is our starting off string, help in this case, at position 3 in our example. So we start off with string out is equal to blank, so we're just clearing this to the output string. We're starting at the first letter, and we're repeating for the length of that string, help in this case, so repeating 4 times. And say set the character to position 1 of the string, so that's H. If position equals char position, which was 3 and that's 1, then do something. No, so we're gonna go H E, and then we're gonna get to L, which is in position 3. But before we do that, what you're doing over here, if you come out of the if statement, is we're saying basically set the output string to join the output string for char. So in the first case it would have come in with H, it would have said this doesn't qualify, so I'm not running this code, so I'm gonna set the out string to H. As it comes around, it's going to set it to, we're ready, it's an H, so I'm going to join H to E. So join H to E, so I'm going to have the letters H E in my string. On the third time around, where these two do match, so the position and the string and the char, so position and char position are both 3, then it's going to set the output string to join the output string, which is H E at the moment, and the add, which was, I think, the letter W. Now we have H-E-W, come down here, add in the letter L, come through the loop one more time, add in the letter P, and so we have landed up with H-E-W-L-P. That's effectively how this function works. So using this, you can obviously extend it. You could have had string in could have been a whole word, or string add could have been words. When it got to position 3, you could say, well, set the output string to join of the start, which is H-E, and you could have put in the word out. So we've gone H-E-O-U-T, and then come through and down the last letters of L-P. So it doesn't have to be a single letter, it could be a whole word you could have inserted in the middle of the word help. Okay, and this is just now executing the program quickly. setting alphabet letters, set the N word to intern arrange. So there was a word list in this program, a whole lot of words. So it's basically saying, set your start off word to some random word. Pick a random character. So pick a random from 1 to 26. So pick the 18th letter, whatever it is, of alpha. So go and pick a random letter out of that. And that is your insert character. Set a random position between 1 and the length of the word. So somewhere in that word, it could even be the end of it. And then it's going to use that function we've just used to wreck the spelling slightly. And then it's going to ask you to fix the word. And all it's asking you to do is enter the correct spelling for that word it generated. You will then retype it. If the answer matches the original word, so the original word, then your spelling is right. Otherwise, it's going to ask you to try again. That's basically just a little quick spelling test application using these functions. Okay, open that project up. Go have a look at the code, see how it runs through and how it works. Okay, now here's an exercise which is not on the thumb drives. So you can try and imagine yourself. This is a very simple one. Basically, the two things you have to do here is type in your name and then get the cat sprite to spell it out. Now, thinking about those two functions we have, the length of string and the letter position of string, how difficult could this be? Well, you'd be surprised, but some of the guys got it right. So basically, all you're going to do is start off with, very much like here, like this one, is you're going to be asking them to enter something and do something with it. Okay, so jumping right in. So basically you're just saying, ask what's your name, set the my name variable to answer, set the letter to 0, and then repeat the length of my name, change the letter of the position by 1, and then just say letter, the letter of my name. So say the first letter, second letter, third letter of my name until you run out of space. So let's go and run this application, see how it works. Okay, so here we have the application. Let's run it, enter my name. Okay, and there he is, spelling it out. Okay, so not a very difficult, and he's even going to spell the space character. There is the space, and so forth. Yeah, we're not going to watch the end of that. So, not a difficult one. Try do this one without looking at the code, and then try hit it. Now, the more difficult one, the secret encoder. Okay, so in this application, I'm going to be asking you to enter in if you want to encode or decode a sentence. You then type in your sentence, and then it must give you an encrypted or decrypted one. So basically, to give you basically what it must do is just say, enter your sentence. I want to encrypt a secret message to my friend. So say, okay, so you want to encrypt it. It'll then say, what is your sentence? And you can say, I really hate the teacher. That's a bad example. but you know what I'm saying. So basically, I really like this boy or this girl. It will then, if you've asked encrypt, it will then spit out a bunch of random characters, which nobody can really read or understand. You could then pass that sentence on to your friend, and if he's got the same encryption code, he would then go and say, okay, I've got this weird sentence, so I'm going to start my app, and I'm going to say, I want to decode it. So say, okay, I'm going to decode, then say, enter your sentence. You then type in those random letters, enter, and it will spit out, I like this particular boy or girl. Okay. So let's say, try it out. I'm not going to show you the code immediately, or go try this out, see how well you do. Give yourself a few minutes, and if you're really stuck, then we can move on to this slide. So here's basically a function. So this is the function which does the actual encoding and decoding. Basically what we have, and I'm going to show you the code in more detail, is we have two lists. We have a list of 27 characters. We could have used two strings and used the position function. I just used a list as an example of merging lists and strings. So you can have a list of letters A to Z in order, and then a space right at the end. And then you have a second list of all the characters all mixed up, but just don't repeat the same character. So you can either go from Z to A backwards, or you can go along the typewriter and just go QWERTY, UIOPASD through that way. Or you can scramble up the letters however you want, just as long as you don't use them more than once. So let's start off with that. Then there's this function. Basically, it comes in saying, okay, so repeat for the length of the sentence, starting at position 1, set letter to 1, and it's going to go and say, if I'm encoding or decoding, it equals E. So I'll show you what that means. So I'll just ask to enter the letter E or D if I want to encode or decode. So I'm encoding E, yes. Repeat until the position, letter position of sentence, so I'm currently at position 1, is equal to a running variable or letter I of my letters list. So I'm saying when the letter, so let's pretend it's the letter A, so if letter position of sentence, so the first letter in the sentence is A, equals item, and letter would be one of letters, equals true, so A equals true, it would jump out. So I'm repeating until that's a true statement. So if it is letter A, it'll jump straight out. It's going to go say set my output sentence, that's a variable output, to join output with that same letter from my other list, so the messed up list, so the first letter in my encryption list. If I'm not encoding, do the same thing, but switch which lists I'm using. So in this case, I'm going from the letters list to the encoder list, and from this one, I'm going backwards from the encoder back to the original letters. Okay, so that's all that this thing does. This literally loops through my sentence, tries to find the letter in that sentence in my list or my other list, gets that position. So letter A will be position 1, letter B position 2, and Z will be 26. And then once he finds the letter in the list, he comes and says, okay, well, give me the same letter in the other list in that position. Or the other way around, same thing. Okay, well, I'll actually show you the code just now fully running. Then to actually run the code, all you basically say is, when I click the flag, ask, are you encoding E or decoding D? Then you set that variable encode to answer. Ask, what is the sentence? You then say, okay, set sentence answer, the out position, just clearing your output string variable and clearing your position variable. Convert my sentence, and then I'm saying, if I'm encoding it, then say your code for your secret message code is whatever it is, else it will say your secret is, and that. And that's basically all this code is. So let's actually go and run it now, and you can see, if you don't understand what I've been saying so far, how it's actually meant to work. Okay, so yeah, we have the actual code. Let's just minimize that a bit. You can see the code. Basically, we can run through, ask what is your sentence, and then encode and decode and spit out the answer. So if we actually have to try and run it now. So are you encoding or decoding? I am encoding. What is your sentence? My real name is Spider-Man. Or whatever. Great, bang, and now we have this weird sentence. Now if we write that sentence down, SMS that to your friend, whatever you want, then he would get it and you say, well, what am I doing? I'm now decoding this message. Okay, what is your sentence? I'm just going to copy that one back again. O-C-A-J-W space P-A-N space O-W-A-S-I-A-I-L-S-X-W-J-O space N. Makes no meaning to me, no sense at all. What is he trying to tell me? My real name is Spider. Oh my word, you don't say. Okay. So that's effectively how you can use this to send and receive encrypted messages. So just to give an idea what I'm talking about, those two lists. So we have the data types. We look at our two lists, and as you can see here, I have letters A to Z with a space. Here I basically just put the exact list in backwards. So effectively, when I put in the letter my, for my real name is, it would have come all the way down to here while I was encrypting, found that M was 13, you would have come to the letter number 13, I said, oh, okay, so I must spit out the letter O when I see the letter M in the original sentence. And then Y comes to Y, that's position 25. What was the position 25 in this list? C. So it would have been a character C, and so forth until it had scrambled your entire sentence. There was this part here. So effectively what he was doing here. When you're decoding, he's doing exactly the same, but backwards. So you would have typed in your letter would have been in, the first letter would have been O, so it would have come through this list saying, okay, go until I find the letter O in the encoded list. O, it's position 13. Well, what was it in the original position? M, so the first letter would have been M, and so forth until he's built up your new sentence. And that's very easily how you can write an encryptor. Obviously, you can scramble these lists up, so each one of your friends can have a different encoded or scrambled list. So basically, even if they had the same program, if they entered up your encoded secret message, they wouldn't be able to decode it unless they knew how you had scrambled your letters. And that's how you can share private messages between friends. Okay. Right, that's the executor. Okay, homework. Work on your project, people. Please remember to work on your project. Check out last week's lesson on lesson 13 on our website. And if you're looking at this, you're probably looking at lesson 14. Next week, we're going to be looking at diving deeper into loops. So looking at the forever loop, looking at nested loops. We've already dealt with them slightly, but just basically looking at how you can go deep and deep into loops, and just probably some of the cautionary things about don't go too deep sometimes, or you might land up with your code doing interesting things. Okay, so do remember to work on your projects. Have a great week, and we'll see you next week.